Hey there YouTube fans, AC Productions here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to install these brand new TST Industries GTR Halo Flush Mounts. These are brand new, just came out from TST Industries, so I just want to give a big thank you to TST Industries for giving me the opportunity to be one of the very few to get these before anyone else. So let's get started. The tools needed for the job is going to be a 4mm Allen key, that's to take out the bolts in the front, and then a small Phillips screwdriver, and that's going to be just to take out that little plastic piece that's going to be over there by the front fairing area, which I'll show you in a minute. Also, don't forget, if you have a little Ziploc bag around, good to have, so you can put your screws in it and not lose them. So once you're done putting your screw in there, go ahead, close up the Ziploc bag, and therefore you always know where your screws are at. Optional tool needed for the job will be an 8mm open end wrench. So let's go ahead and if you've already seen my unboxing and revealing, that's great. If you haven't, I highly suggest checking that out. So TST, for the very first few customers, are going to get it in this very nice tin with a clear glass on the top. Looks really good. And after, you know, taking the flush mounts out, I'll be able to reuse this tin. Maybe put some candies in there or something, so when family and friends come over, you know, they could see what's inside the container. All right, so inside this very nice tin, we have the plastic. This part's actually going to go towards the back end of the flush mount. So let me take that out so I could show you a demonstration. So if you know how a zip tie works or a cable tie works, you know, as soon as you pull on that little strap, this starts to click. Same thing with this one. What we're going to do is we're going to slide it over through here. And then once we get to this part, it's the same concept. So once we put our flush mount in, this part goes in the back, and there's little ridges here that actually go with this bracket, and it just snaps with pressure holding your flush mount on the bike. Pretty cool design. I thought it was going to come with some screws, but no tools really needed to put this part on. If you don't have anything on your bike, this is going to be pretty easy, so you have nothing to take out. But if you're doing this on, if you're trying to replace your stock bulbs with some better looking ones, this is the way to go. Been waiting for this particular mount. I haven't bought any other mounts because I was waiting for this when I first saw them. In the beginning stages, I saw how they looked and I really liked them, so I refrained from buying any other type of flush mounts. Now this one is the crystal clear glass with the white halo ring. So the halo ring is going to show on this outer perimeter of the flush mount, and then the yellow turn signal will be in the center. So when you have just your running lights on, it's going to be the halo ring. Then once you turn on your turn signal, the halo ring is going to turn off, and then the turn signal, the yellow turn signal inside, is going to flash on. If you haven't already bought the turn signal relay, if you're going from regular light bulb to LED, I suggest getting the turn signal relay. TST Industries also sells the relay, and it's a very easy plug and play style of relay. You don't have to do any modifications to the bike. All you do is remove the old relay, put the new relay on, and then you're all set. It's already set at a pretty decent flash rate. All right, so this is how they look like. And on the inside, you're going to see inside of the halo ring, these LEDs right down here, that's what's going to show for the halo color. And now there's many different colors to choose from. Here's a picture of all the halos that they have available. As you can see, it's available in many different colors, and they even have a dark smoke lens cover. So like, for instance, the white that I wanted, I did originally want the smoke cover, but the white didn't show too clearly through it, so I wanted more of a clear look. But again, if you see in the smoke, you see the blue, it looks actually really good with the smoke and the blue. So it gives it that color that pops. So this is the color of the choice that I went with. Originally I did want the red halo ring, but might be in the future that they come out with the red halo ring, and if they do, I'll probably purchase those also. All right, so as you can see, I still have my stock original turn signal. It's because I did shorten the length of how much the turn signal sticks out. And if you haven't seen my video, check it out. If you still prefer the stock look but want them shorter, check out that video. I'll have that in the link below. Also, I'll have a link below where I purchased the TST Industries flush halo mounts. Obviously, I got it from TST Industries, but I'll put a link directly to those flush mount turn signals. All right, so we could do it one of either two ways of in doing this installation. Right now, I'm actually going to do it in the most minimal work effort possible on doing these flush mounts. So first off, we are going to take out these two screws right here. There's one there, and that's going to, besides that cover there, we're actually gonna also need to remove the triangle piece over here, because when we can't just take out this one, there is gonna be a little plastic Phillips screw head here, and to get to that, we have to remove this triangle piece. So on this triangle piece, there's gonna be a screw right here and a screw right over here. Don't mind this, you may not have this on your bike. This is for my battery tender. I disconnected it so I don't have wires all over the place while I show you the installation video. So first off, we're gonna take out this triangle piece with these two screws here. Once we're done with that, I'll show you the next step. Okay, once you take out the screws, just go ahead and grab it from the bottom, pop it out, and for this one, just push it up and then out, and then pull out your triangle piece. So you can go ahead and put that off to the side. So here is this little plastic screw piece I was telling you about. All you have to do is just use your little Phillips screw head, turn it a little bit, and it's gonna come out, and you just pull it out. So once it comes out like that, just grab the edges there, and then just pull out the whole little piece. Okay, next we're gonna remove these two screws to remove this plastic here. So there's one screw here, one screw over here, and don't forget there's actually two little plastic ones on the inside of the cover here. As you can see, there's one right over here, and then if you look on this side, there is one right there. So just use your little small Phillips bit and just turn it and then pull it out like we did when we took out the one right over here. Okay, so next we're gonna do is we're gonna remove this plastic and just grab it from the inside and pull up on it, and then just remove it out of the way. So up and then push and then pull it this way, so towards you, towards the back. Okay, once you take out that big plastic piece, if you look down in between this plastic and the fender, right by that box right there, that box is my ballast for my HIDs. So right underneath that, you're going to see where your turn signal is going to be located. And if you did my shortening of the turn signals, you would have a bolt there. You probably won't have all these wires I have here. It's just because I have HIDs in my bike. You may still be running a stock setup. So if you feel that this method of doing the flush mounts is too tight for your hand, if you have bigger hands, this might be not a good way to actually access your turn signals. So therefore, I'll be showing you a different way on actually removing this whole fairing to get to the turn signals. So I'm just showing this way. If you have small hands like me, you'll be able to get to this area with no problem. So, but if you have bigger hands, or if you find this part of the installation just a little bit too complicated on trying to get to this area, don't worry, I will be showing you on how to remove this whole panel here to gain access to the turn signal. We'll do that for the other side. Also, if you did do the shortening of the turn signals, meaning that you shortened the length, because they used to stick out to here, now they stick out, they're a lot closer to the fender. If you did do this installation, you're going to also need an 8mm wrench to take out the bolt, because it is secured by a bolt on the other side. Okay, now once you're careful on removing everything all at once, all the spacers and the nut, that's only if you did the short turn signal install. You will be removing all this from there. So once you do so, you can just go ahead and you can put those in your little Ziploc bag for now. Go ahead and throw all that in there for now. Since you got all that out of there already, now all you need to do is just pull on the other side for the turn signal. Okay, once you get it out, make sure you don't pull on it too much, just because it's still connected to the bike. So when you go inside and you trace where the turn signal wire is, and from this side, it's going to come up through here, through this little loop here, through this little loop here, and then there is your turn signal connector. Now to undo the turn signal connector, you're going to notice that there's going to be this little clip right there. That little clip right there, you're going to have to undo it to pull out the connector. And the way I do it is I will use a very small flathead screwdriver to push up on the little tab. Don't go too wild on it, because if you break that clip, you're going to end up damaging the connector, because when it snaps in place, it kind of keeps all the debris out of the connector. And if you break it, you're going to have to find a different method, either buy a brand new connector or a different method to keep it weather tight. So just lift it up a little bit and then pull the connector out from the other side. Okay, once you have the connection free, now it's okay to pull out your turn signal. So here is the connector right here. So just push it through all the plastic, and then carefully take it out from this end. If you feel a catch on anything, just look on the other side to see where it's going through and then just unsnag it from that area. And then take out your whole turn signal.
And there's your whole turn signal right there. Okay, so now let's grab our new turn signal and install it.
Okay, now when you take out both of the flush mount turn signals, there is no left and right. So they're pretty much universal on which side you put them on. So you could put this on the left or the right, same thing, left or right. It doesn't matter. So just letting you guys know that they're not directional on which side you have to put them on. They go on either left or right.
It's up to you if you want to clean this area and have it nice and clean. I think I'm going to clean it because I don't want all this dirt to actually show through the light. It may not, but just I'm going to just try to avoid it. So I'm going to go ahead and clean this area because I want it to look nice and clean for the new installation.
Okay, now that I got my area nice and clean, and if you're wondering what I just used a microfiber towel with some isopropyl alcohol to clean the area very well. Okay, now the area is nice and clean. Now let's get our flush mount and put it through. So now that we have our flush mount, okay, just make sure that when you put it in, make sure that the smaller radius is towards the back end of the bike and the bigger diameter area is towards the front. Get it, just feed it through, and on the same time you want to grab the other side and pull in the wire. All right, let's go ahead and feed it through. It's on the right way, and then push it in all the way in. Once you get it all the way in, what you want to do next is you want to grab your little plastic piece, which is this one right here, and then put it through the wiring. So that way, when you push it to clip in, it'll seat nice and flush onto the thing. So let me show you that part next.
Okay, now here's the top view. Here's our little plastic piece. Now, when you install this plastic piece, make sure that this flat part goes towards the bike. So like this. So just make sure that this flat part goes towards the bike. You don't want to install it this way, because it won't fit and it won't work. So these little flat arms are gonna go sitting this way on the bike. So let's grab our cable. This is our turn signal for the flush mounts. And you wanna install it like so, put it through, and then just follow it all the way down till you get to the actual flush mount itself. Now I'll try to do the best I can on filming this part. It is a tight space, and I'll see what I can do for you guys.
Okay, we're gonna try out this angle or view. So while you're actually getting that little plastic circle piece in place, as you can see my hand on this side, you wanna make sure you have it in the right position with the bigger part of the circle facing the front of the bike. So as you can see, here is the bigger part of that circle. Here's the smaller end of the circle. So just make sure you hold it in place and line it up to the circle of the hole for your flush mount. Once you have your one finger on this side and one finger on that side pressing against the fender, just hold it there in place, grab your flush mount, feed it through, and then you should be able to start hearing the clicks as you press it in. So get it in there. All right, now go ahead and just press it in place while still holding that bracket on the other side. You may have to wiggle it around just to get it seated and correctly on there. Just take your time in this department because you want to make sure that everything goes well. And at the same time, from the other side, push it in to get it snapped in place even more. I think that's pretty much it. So let me show you from the other side on what I'm actually doing to press this in place. I think for the most part it's already in there, but from the other side, let's just make sure.
Okay, so from the inside view, you could see that we have our flush mount in, and here's that plastic bracket, and here's the little arms who push it in, so that way as you press this little arm in, from the other side you're pressing flush mount even further in. So as you could see, it's not completely on there. I think there is a little bit of space. Let's see how much more tighter we could get this little arm. So just try to do the best you can. If it doesn't click anymore, then it's on there securely. And if you ever wanted to remove these, just this little tab right here, just press it and then push it from this side. So with one finger, press it and then push it from the other side, and the flush mount will come out fairly easy. So I think that's pretty much about it for actually pressing it on there. I don't think it may go any further. And it's on there fairly good. I don't think it's going to go anywhere at all. The design is pretty good quality. Now that you already set this part in there, and as soon as you got it on there good, now what you want to do is you want to grab the cable from the turn signal, which is right here, and then just bring it to the connector and then connect it on back to your bike. Okay, so here is our connector, and then here is our turn signal from the bike. So all you need to do is just plug it onto the bike. Just make sure that when you do it, you're going to notice that there is this little tab here on the turn signal flush mount, which is going to have, it looks like pretty much an arrow. So just make sure that this bigger part of the arrow is going into where this tab is. So if you look over here, that's where the tab is going to meet with this one, and it should snap right in place. So here is that big part of the turn signal, the connector. And as you see, there's that little indentation that's going to correspond with the little tab here. So just go ahead and slide it in place and wait for the snap.
Okay, there's a snap, secure connection, and now you're all set for that side. And then just go ahead and tuck your cables right back into this little pocket area. And that concludes that the installation for this side of the Halo flush mounts. And so far, given the bike a lot more stealthier look, now I don't have those big stock turn signal bulbs sticking out on my bike, and it gives the bike a lot more of a cleaner look. Okay, so now we're just going to go in the reverse order of putting everything back together. Now that we got our flush mount already set, we already connected it. Now we're going to go ahead and we're going to put this plastic piece here, and then don't forget to put that little plastic Phillips head here. And on the inside, you're going to have those two pieces on the inside as well as for those plastic screws. Let's go ahead and get that done. Okay, now that I got that plastic piece in there, and when I run my finger through the side, I could feel that smooth transition from the other piece to from this plastic piece to the one at the bottom, and there's no real big gap. If you don't feel that nice smooth transition, then you need to realign it and put it in place properly. Okay, next we're going to do is we're going to put our triangle piece that goes right over here. Okay, now we're done already putting our triangle piece. Pretty much everything that we did for this side of the bike is going to be the exact same thing we're going to be doing for the you'll be doing for the other side of the bike. That's if you did the shortening of the turn signal bulbs from before. Now I'm going to show you a different way on actually removing the whole entire fairing, and we're going to be doing that with the other side. So now this applies if you still have your stock turn signals on your bike, or if you have some different ones on your bike. Maybe you bought your bike used and it came with some different flush mounts. So now this is going to pertain to that type of disassembly of the bike. But if you did this, if you did it this when you found this way to work out for you, just do the exact same process for the other side. Okay, on this side, we're going to do the disassembly of the bike if you still have your stock turn signals, or if you have some different aftermarket turn signals and that's the way you bought the bike. If you did buy the bike used and you have a different style of turn signal there and you're going to replace it with these new ones. So this is going to be disassembly of this whole fairing right here, and we're going to try to do it without actually taking apart on this side. So let's go ahead and let me show you everything you're going to need to take out this whole fairing to get access to these turn signals. So first off, and what you do on this side is going to be the same thing on the other side. So we're going to have to remove this plastic piece. So it's going to be a 4 millimeter Allen key that would go in here. So this screw here, then the screw over here, then it's going to be a small Phillips that's going to go and taking out these little plastic ones. So there's one right over here. And if we move the handlebars, you're going to notice another one right there. I'm going alongside over here on the side. Next, we're going to remove this triangle piece. And that's the same thing, 4 millimeter here and over here. And on the other side of this, there's going to be a little plastic screw you're gonna take out. Next, after that, we're gonna have to remove this screw here. Also, it's a 4 millimeter, that one right here. Towards the bottom, there's gonna be one right here. All right, so let's go ahead and let's remove all those pieces. Okay, now let me show you the tools needed for this type of removing of the panels. You're gonna need a Phillips screwdriver, a small screwdriver, a little flathead, a 10 millimeter socket with wrench, a Ziploc bag, put all your little screws, and then a 4 millimeter Allen or hex key to take out these screws here. And if you're wondering about 10 millimeter, that's gonna be to remove a bolt that's holding this whole fairing, but when we get to that, I'll show you that part. Okay, now let's go ahead and remove those panels. Okay, now that you remove that triangle piece on that side to get an access to removing this panel here, now we're going to get our 10 millimeter and we're going to remove this bolt here. Go ahead and remove that bolt. Okay, now that you remove that bolt, next you're going to remove another screw, and that's located here on the front of the bike. It's going to be a Phillips head, so go ahead and remove that part of the screw. Now upon removing this plastic piece here, you're going to notice that there's going to be another bolt over here, and that bolt is going to be a 10 millimeter. Get back there and go ahead and remove this bolt also. After you remove that 10 millimeter bolt over there, if you look on the inside, there's going to be two Phillips head screwdrivers that you're going to, screws that you're going to need to remove. One being right here after I refocus. So one screw is going to be right here. No, it's kind of dark, but one screw over here, and then there's going to be another one here on the top. So here's the one here at the bottom. Then there's going to be one at the top. So here's the one here at the top. I know it's kind of hard to see because I do have some LED wires there, but if I remove them, you could see that there is a screw right there. On your bike, you may not have LEDs here, so you'll be able to find this screw fairly easy. And this is towards the top of where the headlights are. So if I zoom out, you could actually see exactly where I'm talking about. So there's just gonna be the two screws that you need to remove at the top part. Then lastly, there's gonna be one screw here at the bottom. And as I zoom in so you guys could see, that's gonna be the last screw you need to take out so you could we could remove this whole entire fairing. And then also there's gonna be a screw, which is gonna be a plastic one that's gonna be at all the way here at the bottom. And it's gonna be right here. It's gonna be a little plastic one. on, so remove that with a Phillips head and that should just pop right out. If you have a little bit of difficulty removing it because there is a lot of dirt and grime that comes and hits this area, you could use some needle nose pliers, which I have right here, and then just go ahead and just pop a little piece out. But make sure you go, when you remove it, don't break it.
Okay, after you remove all of those screws, now you'll be able to remove your fairing. You may have to do some wiggling around and moving some of the plastic here, but it should be able to come out. We'll move this whole plastic piece forward, same time being careful there. So once you move this forward, then you can just go ahead and pop it out. There you go. Like I said, just be careful with the tabs, and this will gain you access on removing the panel. We're not going to remove the panel all completely. We're just going to try to keep it on the bike as much as possible. But at least you're going to have this area over here to get and have more easier access on removing your turn signal. Okay, now that we have our panel free, and now we have a lot more space to work, and if we need be, we could pull on the fender just a little bit more to gain access to the turn signal bolt. Now you may have a different setup. I did shorten down my turn signals, and that's why I have a bolt and some spacers. If you have the same setup, then just go ahead and remove the bolt with the 8mm open head wrench and take this out. And once you remove the screw, then you could go ahead and just follow the line of where the turn signal is, and then go ahead, and since it's right here, then just go ahead, get your small little flathead screwdriver, pull up on this little tab right here, and disconnect the turn signal. Now once you disconnect the connector from the main harness, just go ahead and just pull it out from the other side, guiding the cable, and then there you get it, taking off your turn signal. Now say you did not do the shortening of the turn signals and you still have the stock setup of your turn signals. I'll show you how to remove that also. Okay, so if you are still running the stock setup of your turn signals, then this is how your turn signals are going to look like. They're going to be the ones that extend out furthest from the bike. And on the inside, when you look inside, let's pull this out a little bit so you guys could get a better view. Okay, so from the inside, here's a little bit better of a view for you. So when you pull this out, you're going to notice that you're going to have this clip, and it's just a rubber piece that's holding this whole assembly in. So to remove the clip, all you have to do is just move up on the rubber piece here, and then there's going to be a rubber piece here at the bottom. So move this one down, move this one up, and then there's this plastic. So with one hand, I'll see if I could do it for you guys. You may need two hands to do this. So we'll move this one down, we'll move this one up, and then with my other finger, I'm going to push up onto this clip. So this is just a little plastic clip that's holding it in place. So just go ahead and push it up. Once you push it up, now you could release it. Just remove that off to the side. And then for this part, you might have a little bit of a difficulty pushing this out because it's really on there. So all I had to do to push it out is just squeeze the rubber and then slowly but surely on from the other end, also pull it out. So while you're pushing in from here, pull it out from the other side. So we're just going to go ahead and squeeze over here and push it in. At the same time, from this side, we're going to be pulling out. So you're going to have to just wiggle it around and squeeze it, the rubber from the other side, and just try to do the best you can on removing it. So there you go. So it took a little bit of elbow grease to do it, but once you get it out, you could just go ahead and we'll put this off to the side for now. And then on the inside, we have to just disconnect the turn signal. So once you disconnect the turn signal, here's the turn signal disconnected. Now it's okay. Now you could go ahead and just remove the turn signal altogether. Okay, so here is our flush mount. And before we put our flush mount, again, I'll probably clean out where the turn signal is going to go. Okay, so that's where our turn signal just came out of. And as you can see how dirty it is, I'm going to clean out that area so we could put our brand new flush mount. Okay, now that we put that away, now we're going to grab our flush mount, and we already cleaned that area. So now let's get our flush mount, and we're just going to feed it through the hole of the turn signal. And at the same time, we're going to be pulling the wire from this side. Okay, once we get it on there, you can just poke it through if you like. So now we're going to grab our plastic mounting thing. I don't know what you would call it, but our little bracket here. So we're going to put it through the hole and make sure that you have the smaller part towards the back and the bigger part towards the front, and make sure that these little arms, the flat part, is facing fairing. Let's go ahead and put that in. So as you feed it through, it's kind of probably hard to see. Let's see if I could zoom in a little bit. Here's a little bit of a zoom up. Okay, so let's hold that piece. Now we're going to push our flush mount through. So there's our flush mount. Now what you want to do is you want to hold it in place from the other side. And then on this side, as we're holding the other side with the flush mount, we're pushing it forward. That way we could put our bracket and slide this in place. Let's get that over on the flush mount area. Okay, once we get it lined up, now we want to go ahead and we want to just press down on this bracket and secure it in place. All right, once you get it on there and you don't hear any more clicks, it's already securely in place. So we could get one more click in there. Nope, that's pretty much it. All right, so now we already have that installed.
Now let's go ahead and we could plug in our cable. So let's grab our cable here. And again, when you're looking at the connector, you can have this like almost looks like an arrow pointing up. So you want to make sure that this big round part corresponds to the connector's little tab, which is right there. So it's going to go ahead and put that in there. Wait for the click, and you know you have a secure connection. Okay, now that we have our secure connection, at this point, if you want to test out your signals before installing everything on the bike, now would be a good time to do so, because if there's any complications or anything that's not correct, now would be the good time to actually fix that. Okay, so we got our connector on there. Just going to put our fairing up a little bit. Let's test out the turn signal. All right, so let's go ahead and turn on the bike. We're just going to put it on accessory mode. I'm going to turn it on. All right, so now they're working. As you can see on the camera, it just looks like it's all LED when really it's not. So I'm going to take a different view. All right, so now here's a different view of how the turn signals look like halos. As you can see, it's only the outer ring that's actually lit. It looks really nice, I must say. Okay, now we're going to put our turn signal here on the left side. As you can see right away, when you put the turn signal, the halo goes away and now it's just turn signal. Then when you cancel it, it goes back to halo. So it's pretty cool. All right, so now let's check our right turn signal. Now here is our right turn signal. Let's put that turn signal on. Then when you cancel it, we have our halo back. All right, so the next thing we want to do is we want to make sure, now that we know that both sides work, we want to make sure that there's no interference or any other problems that may occur with these new halos. So even though we just checked that they both work, let's see what happens when we put turn signal on one side and how it's working on another side, because some aftermarket turn signals may have an issue. As you can see, they're both on. All right, so we're going to start off with our left side and we're going to turn on our turn signal again. Okay, so we see the turn signal's on here. Now let's check the right side to make sure everything's okay on that side. Okay, looks like we have an issue there. Not sure what's causing it, but I will try my best to fix it and show you in the process. That should not be happening. It should just only be white and stay white. Let's say we have the same issue with the other side. So I'm going to go ahead and cancel that. Now I'm going to turn on this turn signal on this side. This one's blinking okay. Let's go back to this side. And it looks like it's the same problem on this side too. Not too sure why that is, but I'm going to investigate and see what's causing this blinking issue. It should not be this way. It should be where if the one side is blinking, the other side should be at a steady halo operation of white or whichever color you had selected. Let's go ahead and cancel that. Okay, so I'm glad we looked at this before actually putting all our panels back together. But as you can see over here, as our regular daytime running lamps, we're not having that issue at all. So that's good. And as you can see, there is our halo turn signal there. Let's go ahead and put the right side turn signal and see if it still blinks. Okay, it's not blinking. All right, as you can see, the turn signal is on there, and then you could see the reflection there. Okay, so upon investigating, I was doing some tests prior to actually recording it for you guys because I wanted to see if I could fix the problem and then show you what I did to fix it. So that's going good. Now let's go ahead and put our left turn signal. Left turn signal is on, and then let's see how it's looking on the other side. And it looks like the blinking's not going on. Okay, so pretty much what I did to fix this problem, let's just make sure again. There's no blinking going on that side. Nothing going on that side. So if you do encounter this problem where it is blinking like you saw earlier in the video, it looks like it's nothing with the halo GTRs. Actually, what's going on is that sometimes on our bikes, the turn signal switch can get dirty inside. And what I've noticed when I was working on the issue is that when you turn, to get a better shot here for you guys, put the handlebar straight. As when we're riding and you put the turn signal, and you go like that, sometimes the connectors inside actually get dirty. So when you turn it, even though the signal is on, it could be causing an interference into the flush mount where it's not getting a proper connection. And that's why it's causing interference for the other side to blink. So because when I noticed that when I put the signal, if I pressed it a few times to really get that connector going and to make sure that there was no interference, the light actually stopped blinking. Not the yellow, the turn signal, but actually the halo ring itself. So if I were to put the other side, if I gave it a firm press on the switch, you'll see that the light is not blinking anymore. Prior to that, it was blinking, so I gave it a few pushes to really make sure that it was getting a good connection on the other side, and it actually stopped blinking. So if you notice that, just make sure you give it a good firm press to the direction that you're turning. So give it a good firm press, and just make sure that you don't get that interference. So right now, as for me, it actually worked out, and hopefully it works out for you too. So if you notice that you had that same problem earlier, just make sure you give it a nice good firm press. Not too hard, you don't want to break the switch, but just give it a good press on that direction, in whichever direction that you're turning. Because like I said, it looks like that the connector inside this box, the connectors could be dirty or whatnot, and may just need to be cleaned. But if you're able to just give it a good firm press, and that should clear up that issue. So far it's actually working out pretty well. I don't see that a problem occurring again, even if I were not to cancel the turn signal and just go straight into the next turn. There's no blinking going on the other side. Oh, we had a small blink there, but it looked like it stopped. Okay, so that blink was just because it was since I did it so fast that it was going back into white. So as you can see, okay, so that issue has finally been resolved. If you have any other issues going on when you test out your lights, please leave them in the comments below, and I will do my best on trying to figure out what's going on and see if I could replicate the problem on my bike and help you guys out with your issues also. All right, so that would be my conclusion for that. That's all that you needed to do is just give it a good firm press on your turn signal. If you're still having the issue, just keep on pressing it until you know you get that connection. And it could be that the little control box inside on that switch, the terminals could be dirty, so therefore it's causing some interference, electrical interference, when you turn from one side to the other side. So hopefully that helps you out. Now let's go ahead and put our bike back together now that we know that our signals are good and ready to go. Okay, now that we were able to fix the problem with a blinking of the turn signals, now it's time to put our bike back together. So now as we're gonna put our bike back together, want to make sure that we line up everything good and right. So let's see, want to make sure that whatever wires we have, we make sure we tuck them inside our fairing. And if you notice here on the headlight itself, you're going to have these little notch areas, and that's going to correspond with the fairing. It has these little plastic nubs that are going to go inside here. Once you get them in here, you want to push back. So put them in there's going to be a spot where it's a little bit bigger on the hole, which is right here. So we're going to put our fairing in, and then we're going to push up towards you to lock it in place. So not only is we got the two over here, we do have a small one right over here in the front. So try to do your best as you can to make sure that you have everything lined up, because if you don't, you're going to notice a really big gap between the headlight and the fairing. All right, so let's get started on doing that. Okay, now that we got it on there, everything looks to be lined up perfectly nice. Now everything is just going to be in the reverse order of us taking it off. And again, if you did it this way, it's going to be the same exact way on doing the other side. So whichever method that you had chosen, whichever way that you found it a lot more easier, it's going to be the same exact on the opposite side. So now let's go ahead and put all our bolts back. And go with the one over here, which is going to be the Phillips screwdriver bit here. Make sure you put your plastic back on, all the screws back. And once you get that main fairing on, it's a good idea to put the 10 millimeter bolt on back over here. So that way it would hold it in place while you put all the other screws back on. So just take your time on putting some of these pieces on. I know they could be a pain in the butt when installing it back on, but just take your time. You'll eventually get it right back on there. So all these screws here, over here at the bottom, triangle piece, and that piece up here. So let's go ahead and put all those screws back in. Luckily I didn't lose any screws today because I had it in my little Ziploc bag. All right guys, I already turned off all the lights in or most of all my lights over here in my storage. We're gonna see if we're gonna try if we can get to see the both sides of the bike with the flush mount. All right, there we go. Now we could see in view both of our flush mounts, and as you can see, they stick out just a little bit, just enough to actually show drivers in front of you that you do have your lights on. And if they were able to see it, they'll still be able to see you doing your turn signals. Well, from this angle you can't tell that they're halos unless you're looking at it from the side, but for this purpose we're gonna put our turn signals that way you can see left and right from this angle. So there is our turn signal for our right side, Now let's do the left side. There we are for the left side. All right, so there we have it. Now, see how they look when they're both blinking. So there we have it. We have it with the hazard lights on. You can see them both blinking. And it's looking great. Going back to regular light, daytime running light. All right, now let's go check off from the side. All right, here we are on the left side of the bike. And as you can see, there is the halo. And if you notice inside the LED, there's gonna be a few rows of LEDs. Then there's gonna be an empty spot and then another little row of LEDs inside indicated by the white. So don't worry when you see that, when you put your signal on, that you see a little break in the LED. It's not because of the LEDs inside that there's no LEDs working in there. It's just that that's how they made the light. So there's gonna be yellow, there's going to be no light in there on the side, there's going to be another little indicator here on this side. All right guys, that concludes our installation for the brand new 2017 GTR Halo flush mounts from TST Industries. Again, I want to thank TST Industries for giving me the opportunity to make this video and also providing me the flush mount. Well, hopefully you guys found this video helpful. Please like, subscribe, and if you have any questions or comments about the installation, or if you run into any problems during your installation, please leave them in the comments below. Also, if you found my troubleshooting helpful, if that had happened to you while your installation process, please also hit that like button and leave a comment that also helped you out if you happen to encounter that problem. And thanks again for watching.